Isn't this a beautiful world? It's so wonderful. It's so full of holy religious people with their religious holy books. And they're all so wonderful. They all get along and love one another and help one another. Isn't it a beautiful world? I mean, just go to the RCC Mother of Harlots Church and take your children there. They will molest them. And they will do all manner of evil to them, and they'll take their money, and they'll tell you how awful you are. You're not allowed to tell anything. And like one Catholic told Harlan, he said, well, there's more pedophiles in the Protestant church than there are in the Catholic church. And Harlan laughed. He said, well, that's something to be proud of. And then you have the Muslims, and you have the atheist, which is really a form of religion. They just call it non-religion. But basically, you have a wonderful world full of religious, beautiful, loving people that just love each other. And they quote the Bible or their other holy books, and they're hypocrites. It's a holy hell. They have this pretend holiness. Look at the Holy Bible. What's holy about the Bible? It's got some writings in it from some people that did love God that were holy, but it's not used for holiness. It's used for evil today. It's used for greed, for greedy preachers to make themselves rich so they can fulfill the lust of their flesh, and for evil people, rulers and preachers, to claim authority like they're speaking from God, using the Bible as authority from God. It has no authority from God. The people that are written in there about it had some authority from God. But just because you have a book about people that did have Christ in their life and did have authority from God doesn't give you authority from God. When the Bible was compiled into an idol, then the devil and his rulers used it to kill and destroy God's people. The most horrendous things that have been done in the world have been done by people claiming to be of God, using their holy books for authority. Wars and persecutions and martyrs that they made out of people. People that are of religious beliefs, the most sanctimonious, hypocritical, evil people in the world use religion for their excuse and their authority. So look at the earth around you. I don't know what percentage of the world holds most of the money. It's a small percentage. And look at all the poor people. Look at the Catholic Church. They are so rich, but look at their people. They live in poverty and squalor and misery. And if they gave all their money and distributed equally amongst all the poor people, the children in the poor countries, then those kids would have everything they needed and everybody would have everything they needed. Why do you need to live in a golden palace adorned with all these jewels and stuff when there's starving kids out there? It's a wicked, wicked world. It's a holy hell here on earth. And they just can't see it. Their greed has blinded them. Their idolatry has blinded them. Everybody thinks they're right and everybody else is wrong. Well, the truth is, everybody is wrong. Only Jesus Christ is right. And you have to give up your will to him. You have to submit fully to him. You don't live after the flesh. You don't get your will. And then you have life in Christ. And our home will not be of this wicked world. We have another home, another world in the kingdom of God, where people won't be controlled by evil. And it's going to be a real holy heaven where there'll only be righteousness. And there won't be right and wrong religious zealots that are full of evil and wickedness, thinking they're right because they have some words from a book that they interpret a certain way. This world was created beautifully by a wonderful creator who sent a holy savior to show us the way and to send the Holy Spirit, which is the gift and promise of God to us, that regenerates us and gives us the nature of God in us. And without this nature of God in us, this Holy Spirit seed in us, then we won't enter the kingdom of heaven. No matter how many scriptures we quote from our holy books, no matter how many commandments we keep from our holy books, you're going to wind up in hell, a real hell. Because you're living in a holy hell now. Holy Spirit-filled Christians, true ones, know that we're living in a holy hell in this world. It's not of God. It's an illusion. It's a strong delusion. And it's not going to end well. You can quote the scriptures and claim the Bible all you want, but it's not going to save you. Get out of the flesh. Get out of religion. Come out of the harlot churches. Come to the living Jesus Christ with your heart through the Holy Spirit. That's your only hope. Otherwise, this holy hell that you've created here on earth is going to burn you and all your books with you.
Who was walking in a valley of sin and shame? The Lord looked down, spoke my name, no lie. In that valley could I see? Well, the Lord said, I want you to do my work. Then yes, Lord, I never shared not a shadow of a doubt. Jesus brought me out. Oh, he brought me out. Got a right to sing, I'll shout. So, those who glad eternally. Been walking out and talking at his command. Not going to stop till he shake his hand. Not a shadow of a doubt. Jesus brought me out. Down in the valley of old dry bones, nothing much there but the wind among.